and joins us here today to share her incredible journey and talk all about her plans for her app, Sweat. Big round of applause, Kayla Itsines and beauty wellness expert, Lucinda Pitt.
Doing a very good job. Very good job.
Now, I'm not going to lie, I did curl my body into a couple of last-minute panic workouts just before sitting next to the world's most influential fitness trainer.
Did it work?
Well, I don't know. I'm in the expert, so I must be hiding something, right? But that's not going to work for me, is it? The last minute doesn't work.
No, unfortunately.
Yeah, sorry. You've heard it here first, everybody. If you win. Now, I know rather than sitting on this couch answering my questions, you would probably prefer to train this audience like a spontaneous boot camp. So, even though they're not dressed for it, should we do it?
Yeah,
okay. Maybe that's bizarre 2020. Yeah, next time. Maybe let's just think about your boot camps, because they are phenomenal in terms of not just the amount of people that show up, but the vibe that you create. And I know that you've done them in New York, you've done them all over the world, but the first one you did, it was 4,000 people turned up.
Yeah.
And how many were you expecting?
700, I think. Well, that's what I thought, because we did one in Adelaide, so Adelaide and Perth, I've got like a similar size as my friends in Perth. But, you know, so I went there and I was sort of like, oh, so what's this line for? And they're like, yeah, it's your boot camp line. I was like, one of my boot camps up there, like, you know, this is the line. And they ended up being, yeah, 4,000 people. And then the police came. They were like, excuse me, and I was like, and everyone was like, ooh, and then someone, they just go, can we grab a photo? And they were all like, ah! I was like, what's
this? It's a good risk with a crowd of women in lycra. Hopes, the police need to get it.
Just part of the sound, but it was hilarious occurring.
And what's it like mass training happening for you?
I think it's like, yeah, it's pretty nerve-wracking, like, you can understand, even
yesterday.
Oh, yeah, even like now, I'm nervous.
You don't need to be nervous.
She might be nervous. But once you get up there, once the music goes on, and I've been a personal trainer for 10 years now, so I think I get straight into it, and I feel like I know what I'm doing, what I do every day, so, yeah.
Have you got plans for any more boot camps?
Yeah, absolutely.
Great, so it's a watch this space.
Watch this space,
okay.
Yeah, definitely. Like, head in the start of next year, I'm hoping to start up again, definitely.
Right, because you've been taking your time to
get
back after you've had a baby.
Yeah, I'm cesarean, so I'm like, I've watched my clients, and I watch other clients in the gym, like trying to get back into it too fast, and it's just, yeah, you can injure yourself quite easily. There's not, I wouldn't want to be on stage, I'm going to do something like, oh, I'm going to go, like,
yeah.
So, yeah, just making sure I'm all good, working my health care for
you.
Yeah, thank you.
Was it emotional? Sounds like a weird question, but it's emotional when you turn up and you saw all those people there for you, inspired by you. How do you kind of process that?
It was pretty emotional. The first one in London, so my team told me that there was no one there. This is my biggest fear, because every time I go to boot camp, I feel like I was in the shop because they traumatized me. So I was in London, and I'm like, oh, it's kind of like, it's alright. I was like, oh my god, we flew all the way to London, like, it's alright. So I opened the doors, and I'm like, are you ready? Like, don't be disappointed, like, it's okay, like, you're fine. So I was like, oh, great, like, this is gonna be. And I opened the doors, and it was packed. And everyone started crying, and I started crying, and then my team was crying. I don't know why I walked down this aisle, and then I got to stage, and I think it's just like the vibes. I think it's like you change someone's life, even though they change their own life. People are like, oh, you changed my life. I'm like, you kind of did that yourself, but thank you.
You're the glue that unites the whole community.
Yeah, it's nice, and I feel like I have a big responsibility. I don't feel pressure, but I feel like I definitely have a responsibility to everyone, even here today, watch what I say. I don't say anything bad, but it's sort of like, don't be a bully on stage and say,
sure.
You know, like, have a responsibility to give the right information and, yeah, go teaching, wanted to be a PE teacher. I was actually kind of like, at the start of my personal training course, and I was like, I want to be a PE teacher, I don't want to be a personal trainer. And then when I started personal training, I was like, no, I don't want to be a PE teacher, I definitely want to be a trainer, I didn't even know what it meant. And yeah, I loved it ever since then, so.
So you do your dad's been an inspiration.
My dad, yeah. Wanted to play soccer. I think every group dad wanted to play soccer for some reason. But he was great. Like, he was like, all right, like, do 10 push-ups and, like, run around and then you go to your friend's house. Okay. Like, wow. He was just so
it's like motivating you. That was most people like, you know, you can't watch TV tonight.
Yeah. Once in a while, I'd be like, you can't do 20 sit-ups. Like, yes, I can. Like, I was so young. But, like, I don't know. He got me into it. He made it fun.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah.
You are very close to your family. I know on social media you talk about them a lot. Very close. Big group family. I'm really interested to know how they talk about you now and considering all that you've
achieved. I heard this girl about me now, they go about arms.
Yeah, you
know. Like, who are you?
Oh, well, I'm okay.
My grandma says, where's my baby? Where's my baby? That's not the time, which is actually great. my family, they talk about me, they're, I mean, to describe me, they're like generous or nurturing, something like that.
They're not aware that
they're aware that
you are the
streets. I'm doing morning, like, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I was like, what's
your work? Clearly. No, what I was going to ask was, are your parents aware that you're Australia's top self-made businesswoman under 40?
My parents
are huge.
My parents are proud of me and everything I love. My grandparents have zero idea what I do. Zero. I end up with a newspaper and it's like a drama because like I've done something, my face is on the front of the newspaper. What did you do? Like, we're angry.
That is a very great response, isn't it?
So great.
What did you do? You're in trouble.
I find your face on the front of the newspaper. That's a good thing. But yeah, I ended up with a great newspaper and then they sort of got it. But
oh, so you really made it when you get a great newspaper.
Yeah.
Then they realised.
Yeah.
Right. Talk about body positivity. Focus and a very welcome focus, and really driven by social media last couple of years. What does body positivity mean to you personally?
That's a good question. It means confidence, feeling good about yourself, who you are, where you live, what you look like, what you eat, feeling comfortable within yourself. I think that's what body positivity. And I feel like you feel confidence. I don't know if you might disagree, but I feel confident, I'm most confident when I do things for myself. I said this yesterday as well. When you do something little for yourself, go for a walk or workout, that's when I feel most confident, especially after having a baby. How many of you have had a baby or have kids? Yeah, right? So it's like, you feel like you're not yourself, or you don't have time for yourself. You start doing things, you start feeling strength come back, especially after cesarean. Well, my natural birth, whatever, but I couldn't speak to cesarean, but you're almost like, you can't move.
Yeah.
So you regain strength, you feel amazing, yeah.
We do a workout, so they're 28 minutes. How did you land on 28 minutes? Is that the sweet spot for change? Do you just want to get down
now?
How did you land?
I'll tell you the real story about how I landed on 28 minutes. I just pulled that number up anyway, okay guys? So I used to work at a women's only personal training centre, and the joke was, so it said like someone's name, the trainer's name, and then it would say the last thing underneath. So it would be like, Kayla Itsines, 30 minutes next to man box, 45 minutes next to man box, and you go, and you'd be like, oh, I want to train you. Any longer with Kayla than 30 minutes. Like, all the ladies were talking, like, you do not need longer than 30 minutes with her. So I would make my session with 28 minutes, and I would smash the session out with ladies, make sure they do everything properly, but just, because you remember 10 years ago, I wasn't really a thing. Locked arms and weights, we were very scared of.
Yeah.
So I wanted them to be empowered, I wanted them to do a locked arm, like, I don't want them, women, honestly, I know this sounds dumb now, but you're going to be like, no way, but women just be like, no.
Why is it? only three.
Three times a week, 3 to 4 times a week for 20 minutes, and then I'm going to walk on the off bike, so it'll be Monday, workout, Tuesday,
Wednesday. So it's actually very doable. So you think most of the days, I think most of the time, unless they're training someone, they're working out all the
time. No. Right. No one has time for that. You're still a human. You still have things to do.
True. Custom plus, like she drives around. And I've seen lots of photos of that's great, don't do anything.
In fact, Toby said it well, he said it's not an influencer, but an influential. So I hope to be influential and hope to influence something, even women, but I'm not an influencer. I don't feel like I am. Soap. I use that on my skin. I used to set a poop to get my makeup off. I set a poop oil skin. The gentle skin one does nothing for me. happen when you're like, if burning, it's working. Like,
for an asthma.
Yeah, so I just threw acid, way too many acid products.
So you're reformed AHA, VHA.
Yes. Seriously, I thought that you just like, keep stripping down, and just strip down too much, and it just becomes inflamed.
Yeah,
like you get hormonal dermatitis, and that's why you use that charcoal.